Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Trans-Siberian Orchestra! has come and passed like moments through an hourglass. But at the end of this year's trail, an offering, a final tale, of love long lost and then refound, and the child by which those dreams were bound, of a dusty hotel that was long past old, and the shadows and memories its hallways still hold, where the tragically beautiful and the beautifully tragic drift through this night in a last quest for magic. And so it was here that a young girl all alone, wearing a Russian-styled coat, did suddenly appear. And she seemed to be on her own, for no adults were near. But children, my dear friends, are God's greatest work of art. And in the story unfolding here this night, she has a most important part.
In the night, in the cold winter light, a child stands alone and she's waiting. And the light that's out there, it just hangs in the air, as if it were just hesitating. And the snow, it comes down and it muffles the sound of dreams on their way to tomorrow. And when they appear, this night will hold them near, for where they will lead, she will follow. For here in this city of lights, this evening awakens the dreams that it might. The winter, its conscience, the spells it will weave. The snow gently covers the ground, Christmas Eve. Seen on this night is an ancient hotel, where shadows they do tend to wander. And the ghosts that live here hold each moment so dear, for time's not a thing one should squander. And they recount their sand as it runs through their hand, and examine each moment for meaning. It can be wished upon till the moment is gone, like day disappears into evening. For here in this city of lights, this evening awakens the dream that it might. The winter, its conscience, the moment is seized. The snow gently covers the ground, Christmas Eve.
Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas.
The dream still wanders as it was meant to be. And every year this night grows fond. Children and circumstance caught this child to dance as the world turns around. Candlelight, and somehow we start to believe.
In the night and the dream, as it cuts through the noise, with the whisper of snow as it starts to deploy. In the depths of a night that's about to begin, with the feeling of snow as it melts on your skin, and it covers the land with a dream so intense that it returns us all. Child's innocence, and they once you thought most that could never exceed.
And so it was, in front of this hotel, where the young girl had arrived. And standing at one corner was a young man who caught the young girl's eye. He had a small group of children gathered round him there, who were quietly listening, which for children is quite rare. He was telling them a Christmas story about how all men are brothers. And when the story had ended, the children clamored for another. They liked his stories so much, they begged him not to let it end. So he told them about the Wizards of Winter, whose winter ball they must all attend.
Thank you. And
heard the sound of music from somewhere else close by. And she followed the trail of those new notes till she found herself inside an old blues bar with a piano player there, playing with a bluesy honky-tonk sound. And everyone who entered that room depressed, he turned their night around. One by one, he'd draw those people out of their self-imposed cage. And before they realized it, he had them singing on that stage.
The night in New York City, snow come down, looks real pretty. Don't know how, but sun meet anymore with Jennifer Martin playing for the bar. Inside, the lights are low, but each song has its own glow. As he floats them through that smoke, yeah, we just can't believe he's really there. How old is he? Cannot say. The plans that talk can't away. And on this night, I somehow believe him. Knows every song that Christmas got. Even once my brain was dropped. Just him and that old fir tree. All it up this night, electric blue. York City, snow comes down, looks real pretty. Can't believe, but somehow there you are, talking to strangers, sitting across the bar. Suddenly, all the laughing, this not smart, always crafting, building bridges nearly everywhere. It's so off, well, it just fails to stare. Outside colors, lights that bleed. The snow is white and the colors need. Has it just come down like pure salvation? It offers all its amnesty and makes your neighbor different, see? By the light of that fir tree, and this old bar electrified and blue. Hey, give me some of that bluesy piano. Oh. I got a drop that simple childhood view of salvation. Perhaps that's how it was always meant to be. And the more I add up all this information, it all go down in the end to you and me. Yeah, that's right. Then you look around till you find your phone, and you call your mom and everyone at home, and the bar looks on. And it stopped at you when you talked to folks you had seen in years. And the snow comes down and the children play. The bread of God never goes away. The childhood prayer should never be denied. And the night rolls on till it's Caroline. Down to one, I
guess it kind of fits the situation. Ornaments still shining bright, watch them glitter in the night. Just that old fir tree and me pulling up this night in electric blue. Electric blue.
Thank you.
one looking at their watch. And just when you thought it could not get any more intense, they would turn it up a notch. As if unhappiness was somehow by his heart preferred. And as the businessman exited the door, he heard someone complaining on the TV. It was the Grinch ranting against Christmas. And this businessman found that he agreed. Columbia, South Carolina. Thank you.
stable in a manger in the cold winter there. In the arms of his mother, a child lying there. In a city, in a village, though the years have gone by, a child still remains with the dream still close by. And each year on this night, that child taken for the sake of a brother, for the child who's forgotten, for the dream that is still lying there.
Thank you.
man was not always like the man he had become. And you may have wondered how that change had happened and when it had begun. He grew up believing that man was made in the image of God. He went to school, observed all the rules while working very hard. In college, he met the girl who did become his wife. And when she told him that they would soon be having a child, he thought he had the perfect life. But his wife passed away during the delivery. And that was not all that was wrong. His newborn son had been cut off from oxygen, which the doctors said was for far too long. He'd never hold a job, the doctor said. Learn to read or even talk. And it would be a miracle if he even learned to walk. There is no reason for this life, the father cried. Why does he even exist? And if he had never been born at all, there is no way he'd have ever been missed. If man is made in God's image, then something here is surely amiss. For in the child I now see before me, there is nothing of God in this. And then he asked to have the child placed in a state-run home. And after he had signed the papers, he walked into that night alone. Now the old man was nearing a toy shop where he could hear a music box kind of sound from a miniature carousel with its miniature horses all circling faithfully around. And a little girl, wearing a Russian-styled coat, was carefully looking inside at the horses and knights and the trains with their lights, as she was imagining they all were alive. chase an elusive snowflake that was determined to reach the ground when she bumped into the old businessman and nearly knocked him down.
Do you have any children?
The child asked the man. No, was his instant reply. And though he said it in his firmest voice, in his heart, he knew he had lied. So he called up the institution where he had left his son to find out if he was still there and alive, wondering if the past could be undone. The operator told him that his son was still alive and had long ago learned to walk and could understand most things people said, but had never learned to talk. She said he was living in a boarding house hotel next to the hospital way uptown. But the file said the hospital was where he spent most of his time. Then she slowly gave him that address, which he carefully wrote down.
Standing all alone, I bled for you. I wanted to each drop my own. Slowly they depart, but fall in vain. Like desert rain, and still they fall on and on and on. Got to get back to reason. I got to get back to reason. I once late in the season, one by one, distractions fade from view. So, drifting through the dark, the sympathy. Mercy inside my heart. Should life be the same? Do girls cry tears? Do they feel years? Is time just moves on and on and on? Got to get back to. I got to get back to a reason I once knew. In this late season, one by one, distractions fade from me. I'm looking for I don't know what. back to reason. Got to get back to reason I once knew. And this late in the season, one by one, distractions fade from view. The only reason I have left is you.
So he got into a cab that took him to the hospital, where he met a nurse by the front door who told him that his son worked with infants born prematurely up on the 17th floor. And once there, he saw his son, who looked like himself when he was a younger man, rocking back and forth in a rocking chair, a trembling infant from a drug-addicted mother held in his hands. But in his arms, the child did not cry, but slept to silent lullabies. And as his son rocked that newborn back and forth, until finally a dream was caught, but still at his rocking, his son faithfully kept, until that poor child's trembling had also finally left. For you see, it's this way with each of us. We all need to be held at least twice. Once upon the day we are born, and once more when we leave this life.
Could this be the face of God?
so blessed. He changes all tomorrows, replacing tears with reborn years in the heart.
Is there a wrong so great in life? It undoes every good we've ever done. Is there an act so good it would undo all our wrongs, every single one. So he took that first step, which was then followed by another. In that room lit so dim, and before he realized how far he had gone, his son was directly in front of him. Then the father noticed a picture on the windowsill, alongside one that he had never seen before, of a little girl in a Russian-styled coat, standing with her parents in front of their store. He now knew the little girl he saw there was a childhood picture of his wife, but it was also a picture of the little girl that he had just met earlier that night. The father realized that those who love, death cannot divide. It only provides an extra soul to watch over us from the other side. And then the son looked up and recognized it was his father who was now standing there, and gave him a smile of pure love and forgiveness. And of the past, he did not care. Then the father turned and walked back across the room, which by now had lost its distance, and went to the nearest incubator, where he picked up a trembling infant, and with the child within his arms, he returned to his son. And at that moment, all the pain within his soul was undone, and he sat in the rocking chair beside him with the life he had retrieved, and side by side, together they rocked all through that lost Christmas Eve.
Night.
So, our story does end exactly where it did start, in that labyrinth of mystery they call the human heart. Hope never dies, at worst, it only sleeps, and all we surrender, Christmas safely keeps. For in the very end, the message that Christmas is always sending is that it is never too late to change any life's ending. Merry Christmas!
Thank you. Cut the face of a crime, sentence no bail. There, in the night, deep in the back through the black, back into life. Of the dark, leaving marks
thank you. This is actually like the point in time in most usual concerts where everybody shut all the lights out. Y'all would yell, we pretend we aren't, you know, the encore portion of the program, but with TSO, we're having too much fun up here. We ain't leaving the stage! Besides y'all, here in South Carolina, you want to hear a couple more songs, right? All right, before we play these last couple songs, we did not forget, but we're thanking last the most important group of people, period, in the history of TSO, and that is you guys, the TSO fans. You're the greatest fans on the planet. The 15 years in a row, we couldn't have done it without each and every one of you. And you're the greatest gift that anybody could ask for this and every Christmas day.
Everything is now as it should be. I have the honor.